It really all began in 2010. We were dealing with lots of rumours about would MOC ever move to the new site, how far behind the builders were, etc. We found that using newsletters had not been very useful, as they didn't get home and the rumours kept happening. Newsletters couldn't deal with the rumours then and there. There had to be a better way. So at the beginning of 2011, when we heard how community authorities in Queensland had used Facebook and Twitter to get information quickly to folk about the floods, we thought that maybe this might be the better way to keep people updated with accurate information about the move. So in very late January, we launched a simple one-pager, the Mark Oliphant College organisational page. My initial thought was that it would be more effective than the newsletter or our website, and as Facebook was free on most mobile phones, what did we have to lose? We were very excited when we got our first five Not Us folk who liked the page. Then it grew to 50, then 100, parents and students, and it continued to grow. People began to interact with the page, not just like it and read information. They responded, more often with positives, but sometimes with negatives or concerns or issues. We were not in total control. That was a bit frightening. So we set out some simple rules with the community. Any abuse or abusive language would be deleted, but apart from that, people could comment or raise issues. It continued to grow. There have only been four deletes and one ban in 6 months, and we responded to three of the deletes with personal messages. We also began to respond to the concerns, not let a post just sit there without some comment or response, and not just respond on the Facebook page, but actually take action at the school level about the concern. Obviously, with the move and new uniforms, there was lots of initial interest. However, we noted that when we posted photos, initially of the new site, then the number of people accessing the page would spike and stay at the new level. It has been amazing. We have been able to do so many things, like alert them when the newsletters, yes, we still do them, are coming home, or posted to the website, or when we have false fire alarms and tell them why they happened, or the break-in. But there was so much more good stuff that people wanted to hear about. Along the way, it seemed the development of other MOC pages was going to happen. This meant we could use the main one for just that main information. The new pages initially took two paths, teacher community information, for example, digital technologies and health and wellbeing, to those that promoted the areas, particularly those that had lots of photos. So we saw sporting carnivals and arts at MOC. And now we see it developed and being used as an interactive curriculum tool with and for parents and students. MOC loved to learn, Miss Grandison at MOC. The growth was amazing, and as staff wanted to start new pages, we realised we needed some simple rules. And we modified those developed by Juliet Heppel to have the MOCster version. All staff follow these. We also had to stop the MOC main page dominating our lives. We can see how Facebook dominates people's lives. We had never expected so many comments raised every day. So we instituted a new special general comments and issues section. We post it once per week and ask for any concerns to be posted there, and we do feedback to those concerns only once a day. There actually aren't that many concerns, far more positives and wanting to be involved. So now to the next developmental stage. Photos were great, but we had always wanted to show the dad in Afghanistan, we have defence families, his child learning in class. So rather than post vidcasts or YouTube, we started our own TV channel so we could post raw footage of the kids learning and teachers teaching, often done with flip cameras or iPhones. These are not for promotion, we don't need the enrolments, but for deprivatising practice, they're naive and raw. The other big development is in starting our first discussion board to collect community information about an issue the community has raised, actual community voice. Sometimes what people post is annoying, untrue, and maintaining the page can be onerous when folk are being negative, but these are the exceptions rather than the rule. 600 people now like the MOC page, and that means there is a direct feed to their mobile phones or digital devices of all these children, young people and their family. There are 9 satellite pages, all of which have their own character and communities. An average post now gets 1,200 to 1,500 impressions, and this means our community are connecting with us like they never did before, and like they connect with so many other aspects of their lives through social media. SchoolNet is no longer a separate entity. We may even be becoming part of their lives.